In this video, I'll be sharing with you the most useful tips and tricks for your product's design and animation. We'll be using Blender to create phone cases as an example. But these principles can be applied on any product using any 3D software, no matter how complex or simple it is. This is not a tutorial, but I have some very cool and useful stuff for you. Starting off with the modeling. I downloaded some smartphone models from Sketchfab and made some cases for them. That's it for today, end of the video, see you next time. No, I used the smartphone model as a reference for the scale. You can always start with a cube, scale it to fit the phone size, and use the basic editing tools in the edit mode. Ctrl B to bevel the edges, scroll the mouse to increase the bevel, I to inset face, E to extrude, etc, etc. You can use the mirror modifier for symmetry whenever you have a symmetrical shape. To make some easy cuts in the model, make sure you enable the bool tool add-on which ships with Blender. Select the shape you want to cut with and shift select your model, then hit Ctrl Shift B, brush boolean difference. You'll still be able to edit your cut in the edit mode. Here, I duplicated the cut and hit Ctrl R to repeat the process. Repeat the process with the whole model until you end up with something you like. For the shading, you can either download your materials online or you can make your own materials. I used both, but the Voronoi texture stole the show actually. With the color ramp node, you can easily control the colors and using a simple noise texture connected to bump with the height value, you can make some nice normals.
Nice.
I downloaded a leather texture from Polyhaven as a blend file. And let me get this straight. The easiest way to get this material is to open the blend file, select the object with the desired material, hit Ctrl C to copy, and in your project, hit Ctrl V. Now we can mark the material as an asset using the assets library. And I'll be honest with you, using the assets library could be very fun and handy. Now let's make our own brand. If you go to Adobe Logo Maker, you'll be able to get your own logo in no time. But what shall we name our brand? It's just about phone cases. My name is Justin. I didn't ask. Just in case. Just in case it is, and I don't care. Select your style for the logo and choose an interesting icon that might fit with your own logo. And you'll end up with a bunch of options and some stupid logos for your brand. Okay, we got our logo, but we don't want it as an image. We want it as a 3D object in the 3D scene. What shall we do? That'll be easy. Just go to any online image to SVG converters. I used picsvg.com. Now you can import your logo as an SVG in Blender. It might be very small once you import it, so make sure you zoom in to see it. It will be selected by default. Now select all of your different curves in the logo and hit Ctrl J to join them. Then right click to convert it to a mesh. Now you can go to the edit mode and select all of them and extrude it up. Smooth shade the object and make sure you enable auto smooth in the object's properties. Now, just like before, use the bool tool. Select the logo and shift select your case. Ctrl Shift B again and we got it. We got our logo carved in our case. Now let's make something interesting. Go to the world shading and add an HDRI to your scene. Connect it to an emission node to control the brightness and make sure you enable bloom in Eevee. Remember, Eevee is your friend. Don't let anyone tell you the opposite. Enable depth of field in your camera and focus on an empty near your object. For the animations, I just made some basic animations, basic movements and rotations, nothing really fancy. If you have multiple scenes with multiple cameras and you want to transition between them, go to your first frame with the camera selected. Hit M on the timeline to make a marker and Ctrl V to bind the camera to the marker. Select the other camera and go to the desired frame where you want to transition. Do the same process again. Now the cameras will change based on the markers on the timeline. I wanted to give each case a vibe based on the color. And to do so, I downloaded some assets using the Sketchfab add-on and started making some stills to be rendered in Cycles, because we'll be rendering the animations in Eevee and the still images in Cycles. You can add an image as a plane as your background using the image as a plane add-on, which should be enabled by default, I guess. Duplicate everything and change the assets and you'll have a nice match cut. I wanted to add some smoke on the cup, so I downloaded a smoke footage from footagecrate.com and imported it as a plane. I connected it to an emission node, mixed it with a transparent node to make it transparent. Controlling the factor with a color ramp makes it easy. And don't forget to change the blending mode to whatever you see fits. Most people use Alpha Hash, but I prefer Alpha Blend because it's less noisy. And finally, I wanted to make a shot for the package. After rendering and editing, here is the final video. Thank you for watching this video. If you found any tips useful, please consider subscribing. And now it's time for you to take action and make the most of your creative journey. Stay creative and see you next time.